President Momo Marcos discusses the government's pandemic response with the country's top health officials. Marcos met with members of the COVID task force, the health department, and state insurer PhilHealth in Malacañang Wednesday. The DOH in a statement said officials briefed Marcos about the country's COVID situation and how to improve the government's response. Also tackled was the Philippines' COVID vaccination drive. The palace has yet to give details on that meeting. The Philippines reports more cases of the more contagious Omicron subvariants. The health department says 43 more cases of the BA.5 and 7 additional cases of the BA.4 have been detected. There are also 20 more cases of the BA.2.12.1. Overall, there are 190 additional cases of the Omicron variant detected in the last sequencing run, bringing the total to 7,919.
The Overseas Workers Welfare Administration says it has appealed a notice of disallowance issued against it by state auditors. The Commission on Audit earlier flagged the agency for its procurement of pandemic supplies worth 1.27 million pesos. The Commission said the purchases made in 2020 from a construction and trading store were doubtful charges. It issued a notice of disallowance on it late last month. OWA Administrator Hans Leo Kakdak disputes claims the hygiene kits they bought were overpriced. He also defends the choice of company from which they purchased the supplies.
Pinagdudahan kami, yun daw pinagbilan namin ay hindi tunay na supplying company, actually trading company siya, at lumabas sa tabloid na hardware daw yung supplier. So hindi naman ito pinabulaanan na natin. Uh-huh. Missing daw yung supplier, nahanap na rin ho natin yan, kabahagi yan ng apila.
The Philippines' population agency aims to keep the country's annual population growth to around 1 million. Population Commission Chief Juan Antonio Perez III says this growth will help the government meet its goals on poverty reduction. Perez adds it will maintain the programs on family planning and on addressing teenage pregnancy under the new administration.
Medyo malaking programa ito at kailangan, lalo na ngayong darating na taon, ang collaboration with local governments because sila yung nagde-deliver mainly ng services. So kami ng DOH nagtutulungan dyan. Pangalawa naming gusto ipagpatuloy na programa yung sa adolescent health and development, lalo na yung pagtugon sa mataas na bilang ng adolescent or teen pregnancy na umaabot pa ng 150,000 a year. So gagawin naming pambansang programa ito, lalo na yung social protection ng adolescent mother and their children. Starting next year, katulong ang DSWD.
Philippine Vice President Sara Duterte leads a budget review of the Education Department. Duterte earlier said she wanted to look into the department's proposed budget for next year as she eyes several educational reforms. Education Undersecretary Ana Sevilla also presented the agency's budget plans in recent years. Meanwhile, the agency is set to release a department order on the implementation of 100% face-to-face classes eyed to begin in November. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. announced a plan Tuesday.
The Marcos administration urged to ensure COVID safety and provide additional funding to schools as it moves to resume in-person classes. The Alliance of Concerned Teachers says schools' maintenance and operating budget should be doubled to make sure they have adequate supplies for a safe reopening. The Teachers Dignity Coalition also asserts it would require adjustments in class size and physical facilities. As for a group of private schools, it wants requirements for in-person learning to be simplified. It points out they're still struggling with operational expenses.
Kami inang galing sa pandemic na ang budget, marami pa kami utang. Hanggang ngayon, lubog pa rin kami sa utang, iba sa amin. At alam niyo naman na nagsasarahan ang mga private schools, no? Plus the fact na mga estudyante namin nagsilipat na.
Nalisa,
mga
no?
Teachers, mga teachers namin naglilipatan na rin.
Meanwhile, a parents' group wants children to be fully vaccinated against COVID before face-to-face classes resume.
Saka po, isa po, sana po bawat school may isolated room. Sana po pag ito ay 100%, mayroong ng nurse at saka may clinic sa school na ready for whatever sa bata. Bawat grades, mayroon tayong teacher na public safety.